In this particular video, I am going to talk about var const on let. So when you need to use the var const on let, let's talk about these things in a detail. So first of all, we will try to understand with this example. So you can notice that we have used the let x is equal to 1, and this is the block scope. So any statement which is written in this curly braces, within this curly braces, is known as a block. So whatever you will write here, that scope is within that block. Okay, so within that in this block it will work, the variable will work and something will work. If not available, then it will go to the outside with it will go to the their parent or their surrounding to find out the value, as you know that JavaScript has a property like that if anything is not available inside, then they will go to their parent. Okay, so I hope you understand. So now let's talk about these things in a detail. So now x value, here you can notice that x value is 1 and defined with the let keyword, declared with the let keyword, and another let keyword is used to define the another value x is equal to 2. Now what will be the output? So in both the cases, I am trying to print the console, I am trying to console the value of x. So let's check it in a detail. So you can notice that value of x is here the 2 and then 1. Why 2? Because now within this block x value 2 is taken from their block, and within that block x value is 2, that's why it is 2. But outside of the block, the x value is 1. Now if you remove this thing from the global, and within the block if you defined any variable with the let keyword, then what will happen? You will access outside of the block or not? Let's check it. So if I will rephrase, you can notice that uncaught reference error, x is not defined. It means that x is not available outside, but it is available inside, because their scope is limited to their block scope. Within this scope means opening or closing curly braces. So I hope that you are understanding. Let's check another example. Okay, so let's talk about const as well. What is the const? Const, if you will declare any variable with the keyword const, then it will also work like a let, but the only difference is that const cannot be reassigned. Okay, you cannot reassign or change the value of the const variable. However, you can mutate. How you will mutate? So I will talk about so now x value, let's change it to const, and now x value is 1. Here I am console log x. Const. In this case, what will happen? If you will do a const here as well, then what will happen? So as per the definition, you cannot reassign or define two times as well. So here you can notice that 2 and 1 is printed, but why we are able to reassign, or again we are able to define the value of x with the const variable? Because the x is limited to their local. Okay, so within this scope this is working, outside it is not working. That's why first of all JavaScript try to find out from the block memory. Okay, so this is a local memory, you can say. So within this scope they will try to find out any variable. If any variable is present, then they will print that thing. If not present, then they will go to their parents, or maybe a global object, because the parent is their parent is global, so they will find try to find out from the global. Now, if you will try to reassign with the const variable one more time, variable, if you want to declare x variable once again, then what will happen? So here you can notice that uncaught syntax error identifier x has already been declared. So it means that you cannot declare multiple times, only one time you can declare with the const variable, but outside it is working. Reason behind, because this x is accessing this, pointing to this variable value, and this is pointing to this variable value, so there are no conflict. That's why you can const, through the const keyword, two times you can declare, but within that scope you cannot. You can also cannot do in this way as well, because it's also a same thing you are trying to define once again, so again the same error. So you try to declare one more time, and since you can declare only one time and you cannot reassign. Okay, suppose if you want to change the value without the const, then what will happen? In this case, again the assignment to constant variable, uncaught type error assignment to constant variable, it means that you are trying to reassign the value of x with the 22, and it is not possible with the const variable. Within this, again you cannot do this thing. Okay, you cannot do these things. Now if you will remove these things, will the x value will be here will be print? Let's check. Again, assignment to constant variable, because here I have not provided anything, so their scope is very scope. If you will not provide any variable, it means that you are assigning the value, and if it is not present, then x will be a global variable. Okay, so this will be a global variable. However, if you use the keyword let, then let's check what will happen. Now you are able to access. Why? Because this let keyword defined the scope of the variable x is within this block, so they find it within that block, that's why they are printing the value of x. So this is not a reassignment of variable x, because within this block it is working. If this will not present, then it will be go to their parents and they will find out from their surrounding state and they will print. If any variable will be present within their scope, then they will access from their scope. Now, so I hope you are understanding. Suppose if you are using here not use any of the keyword let, var, const, then what will happen? So if I will rephrase, then you can notice that x is not defined. X is not defined. But if you will remove these things, x is not defined because of this if. Let's remove these things. This is also a valid block scope. Okay, this is also a valid. So within the curly braces, if you write anything, that's is the block scope. And if I will rephrase, then you can notice the 22 is accessible outside or inside as well, and not because of we removed the if condition, because we have not providing any of the variable name like const, let, var, like that. So that's why if you not provide anything, that even if you will provide the variable like this in a functions, that variable will be becomes a global variable. Okay, this will be accessible from anywhere in the application, in the page. So this will be a global, not only this block scope, but even if you do in a functions. For example, let's check the example of this one. So now I am going to comment these things right now. you can notice that x we are calling the functions x. So during the function invocation, the within that function a value is 1, so it is accessible within this function because this is a functional scope. But it's not like that. You can also able to access outside of the function because you have not provided any of the keyword like const var let. That's why it's become a global variable. So now if I will refresh it, then you can notice that 1 is available outside. Even if it is you are consoling log outside, it is available. Now if you will provide here the var, in this case what will happen, now the scope will be a functional scope. Okay, this will be a functional scope. So now if we'll refresh, then you can notice that a is not defined because a variable is accessible within this function's scope, outside cannot be accessed. However, if a value will be not available within this functions, then you can access from the outside if a value is available outside. Suppose let's say 1. Now a value, if you console log, then a will print 1 because it is accessible from the outside, because in the functional scope it is not present. That's why you can access from the outside as well, because this is a property of the JavaScript. It means you can always access the parent property, but parent cannot access the children property. This is the important and very fundamental in the JavaScript. Now I am going to let's say comment it out, and I hope you understand about the scope. So what is the var? Var is a functional scope. If it is defined in a function, then it is a functional scope, and if it is defined outside of the function, then that will be a global scope. Okay, so what will happen, suppose this is the functions, let's say y, and within that function I have provided these things, and now let's format it little bit. Now here you can notice that you are trying to call the function, and within that function another function is available. So if you will provide here the var x, then this var, the value of the a is accessible within this function's x scope, not in the y. And also if you try to access outside from the global, it will also not possible. So it means that the var is a functional scope. If you will define a variable a within the y functions, and in y function another function statement is available, and from where you can also access, because this their parent is if within the x scope, if they will not find the variable a, then they will try to find out from their parent, and parent having the value of 1, then they will take from the parent and they will print it if it is not present. If it is present, then from the local value this will be accessible. Similarly, if within this function again this will be not available, the value of a, then they will try to find out from the global object, and in the global memory if it is present, then they will print. If not, then this will print that a is not defined, like that. So var is a functional scope, and let or const. Okay, so I hope you understand that let is a block scope, and const is also a block scope. The only difference is that const, through the const keyword you cannot reassign, or you cannot declare twice or multiple times. You cannot declare multiple times one variable. It will be a error, syntax error. So however, it is mutable. It means what? Suppose let's check the example. Now you understand that you cannot change the value of the const variable, but in case of array, suppose that through the const variable you define the array, and this is the empty array. If you want to push anything, then you can do so. So you can notice that I push here the value 6, and now if I will console log, then you can notice that A6 is available. Let's console it, and again I'm refreshing these things. You can notice that is array having the 6 value. It means that through the console log, it means that you can mutate, you can change the value like this. So I hope you understand. If you face any problem later to this, then definitely let us know.